Without global positioning satellites, how will I know where the nearest off license is?
Oh, don't worry, you can just use your A to Z. Hey there, DNews navigators. Amy here, flying you through this episode of DNews with my co-pilot, Trace.
GPS is basically a science-created miracle. In brief and without satisfying detail, GPS relies on a network of satellites in orbit above the Earth that can determine your exact position on the globe.
The thing is, and this is going to blow your mind, there's more than one GPS system. Russia's is called GLONASS, and Europe's is Galileo. Ours is Navstar.
Weird.
And China and India's regional systems, they only work there, are called Baidu and Navic, respectively.
Europe is building Galileo right now and is hoping to finish in 2020, but there's a problem. The clocks on board the satellites keep breaking. Of the 18 satellites currently in orbit, 9 clocks are broken.
This is serious. GPS only works with sat signals, plus mathematics, and nanosecond precise timekeeping. So the ESA put atomic clocks on the satellites to keep things perfectly in sync.
They even have to update them because of the rules of relativity. You can watch other videos all about how GPS works.
The question they're left with is, can they fix these satellites or no?
It really depends on the satellite.
I mean, we've repaired satellites before, like Hubble. The Hubble Space Telescope was launched in 1990 and filled the cargo bay of the space shuttle.
After being placed in orbit, they opened the lens cover and saw... crap. Blurry images. There was a flaw in the Hubble mirror, rendering it crippled. It was a huge embarrassment for NASA.
It took 5 more shuttle missions to repair the space-based scientific instrument, fixing the mirror, replacing and repairing some mechanical parts, and 2 scientific instruments. It was repaired again in 2009.
And of course, the whole thing was totally worth it.
Completely.
But it wouldn't have been possible had the telescope not been designed to be repaired. Not all telescopes are. You can't just fly up to any old satellite and tinker. They don't work that way. Sometimes we have to get more creative, like with the Kepler satellite.
Kepler was launched in 2009. It's designed to spot planets in other solar systems, which requires tracking stars for long periods of time to try to spot planets passing in front of them.
To move a satellite in space for tracking, you can't use thrusters, and you can't exactly get out and push. Instead, they use what are called reaction wheels.
Reaction wheels are a kind of orientation system. Basically, they spin super fast. Think thousands of revolutions per minute, and the sheer force of that spinning motion transfers energy to the spacecraft to slightly adjust its orientation. Spacecraft typically have 4 wheels, each offset from one another. 3 are the primary wheels, and 1's a backup. But at the end of the day, it's just hardware.
Unfortunately, after years of successful planet hunting, the reaction wheels on Kepler broke, meaning that they couldn't spin the telescope around to point it at stars. They now use pressure from the solar wind to hold the satellite in place, plus the 2 remaining reaction wheels, to keep Kepler stable, and it's on a new mission called K2, Planet Hunting Ho!
Aside from hardware issues, though, satellites are also running computer programs, and sometimes even those can cause problems. On July 4th of 2015, NASA lost contact with the New Horizons spacecraft. They got a message at Mission Control saying it was in safe mode, which is like what your laptop does. It's a basic boot up. But it's really not ideal when you're 10 days away from Pluto.
Unlike your laptop, though, the team couldn't exactly pop up there and hold down the power button to reboot it. It was 3 billion miles from Earth, meaning signals took 4 hours to just go one way.
After a lot of frantic troubleshooting, mission scientists were able to reset the primary computer with a set of commands, and after waiting hours to get confirmation from the spacecraft, they were thrilled to see that it was up and running. Pluto encounter saved.
So let's go back to Europe's broken GPS system. It's not a software issue, it's a hardware issue. Short circuits, or so they think. Regardless, the clocks have failed.
Even though we flew up to fix Hubble, we can't do that here. Hubble orbits really close to the Earth, while GPS is really far away, impossible to reach even with the space shuttle.
So we can't fix these Galileo satellites, but luckily there are 4 redundant clocks on each Galileo satellite, just in case. So a single failure, or even many, won't necessarily kill the $14 billion system, but the breaking clocks might cause delays. So, do we stop launching satellites and find the problem?
Or do we keep launching them and cross our fingers that there won't be more failures? Administrators are already thinking about this.
If the clocks keep failing, the satellites might have to be replaced sooner than their 10 to 20 year lifespan. The system isn't even fully operational, it's set to be so in 2020.
But by then, who knows what GPS is going to look like?
Maybe it'll be like an implant in my brain.
Ooh, that would be awesome. For more on GPS and how it works, literally everything you would ever want to know about atomic clocks, relativity, and how you can use your phone to find things, watch this video right here.
Have you ever tried to live without GPS? Seriously, try it! And tell us your thoughts down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews. Thanks for watching.